You are tuned to the 24/7 channel to celebrate the spirit of sports and Olympic Games. We are continuing with the next episode of our special series entitled Olympics, Past to the Present by Nitish Arora.
Hello friends, I am Shalini Mittal. Olympics from the past to the present, we are going to bring to you various shades of Olympic Games. Facts, known and unknown, players' profiles, stats, trivia, interesting stats, experts' opinion, players' speak, and a very special section in which greetings and messages by the listeners and well-wishers of Team India under the section hashtag Cheer for India.
एक खिलाड़ी दुनिया के किसी कोने में हाथ में तिरंगा लेकर के दौड़ता है, सारे हिंदुस्तान में ऊर्जा भर देता है।
वहाँ एथलीट्स दम लगाएंगे, आप यहाँ से हौसला बढ़ाओ। Cheer for India.
Hashtag Cheer for India.
Hello Team India, this is Dr. Aksha Chaman Rao from Jammu, India. And I cheer for you all. I bring special tidings of joy and happiness. And I greet you all a huge victory and success. And I would like to dedicate this special song for my own Team India. And here it goes.
एक खिलाड़ी दुनिया के किसी कोने में हाथ में तिरंगा लेकर के दौड़ता है, सारे हिंदुस्तान में ऊर्जा भर देता है।
वहाँ एथलीट्स दम लगाएंगे, आप यहाँ से हौसला बढ़ाओ। Cheer for India.
Over to the host of the program, Nitish Arora.
Thank you, Shalini, and welcome, listeners. Today we are going to talk about the modern Olympic Games or the Olympics. Olympic Games are the leading international sporting event and they are repeated every 4 years. But there are two Olympic Games. One is Summer Olympic Games and the other is Winter Olympic Games. And the competitions in which thousands of athletes from all around the world participate in various competitions. The Olympic Games are considered the world's foremost sports competition with more than 200 nations participating in it. Normally, the Olympic Games are held every 4 years, alternating between the Summer and Winter Olympics every 2 years in the 4-year period. The creation of modern Olympic Games was also inspired by the ancient Olympic Games, which were held in Olympia, Greece from the 8th century BC to the 4th century AD. Baron Pierre de Coubertin founded the International Olympic Committee, that is IOC, in the year 1894, leading to the first modern games in Athens in 1896. Thus, The IOC is the governing body of the Olympic movement, with the Olympic Charter defining its structure and authority. The evolution of the Olympic movement during the 20th and 21st centuries has resulted in several changes to the Olympic Games. Some of these adjustments include the creation of the Winter Olympic Games for snow and ice sports, and the Paralympic Games for athletes with physical disabilities. We also have the Youth Olympic Games for athletes that are under the age of 18. Apart from Olympic Games, we have 5 Continental Games. They are Pan America, African, Asian, European and Pacific Games. The world of games for sports. Do you know that modern Olympic Games were cancelled in 1916, 1940 and 1944?
Olympics trivia, the known and the unknown.
Interesting trivia. Do you know that the Cold War limited participation in the 1980 and 1984 Olympics?
Player's profile. What makes the champion?
Age 21, Deepika Kumari is having a world ranking of number 1, the highest world ranking in the world. She belongs to Jamshedpur and started her archery career in the year 2006. She is a right-handed archer and her hobbies include songs and food. A look at her career so far. She has won 2 gold medals in World Archery Youth Championship that was held in 2011 and 2009, and a bronze medal in the team event in the year 2011. In the World Archery Championships, she has won 2 silver medals, won both in the team events in 2015 and 2011. In the World Cup Finals, she has won 4 silver medals at the individual level in 2015, 2013, 2012 and 2011, and 1 individual bronze medal in 2018. At the World Cup stage, she has won 10 gold medals, including 4 individual gold medals, 2 of which were won in 2021, just very recent, and another 2 in 2018 and 2012. She has won 6 gold medals in team events, and again, 2 of them in 2021, and 2 in 2013, and 1 each in 2011 and 2014. At the World Cup stage, she has also won 11 silver medals and 7 bronze medals. Deepika Kumari is highly decorated archer from India and our best bet for Tokyo Olympics. Go for gold, Deepika.
The expert's opinion, the predictor pundit.
And the expert with us is veteran sports journalist IG Rajaraman. Raja, welcome to the program. And what is your prediction, the predictor pundit?
First and foremost, and we look at it in alphabetical order, although like I said, this is not so much a formal conversation that we are having, but I guess we will do well in archery. Remember, Deepika Kumari is world number 1 in the women's individual event, and they've been training very hard, and Deepika can win an individual medal. But again, archery depends on luck of the day, depends on the kind of draw that you come up against. And then the men's team, they will surprise a lot of people because they have beaten teams like the United States of America, they've beaten Italy, they've beaten China, they've beaten Korea, and they know what it takes to win big championships. The men archers will surprise. So that's archery for you.
Players speak, those who matter the most.
Well, India can definitely boast of for having a world champion in Deepika, as Raja said. So why not have it straight from the horse's mouth, Deepika Kumari.
मैंने बैम्बू ड्रॉ से स्टार्ट किया था और फिर धीरे धीरे मैं मॉडर्न वॉक पे आई थी. बहुत अच्छी रही स्टार्टिंग में, थोड़ा सा स्ट्रगल हुआ था बिकॉज फैसिलिटीज वहाँ अच्छी नहीं थी. उसके बाद एक साल आर्चरी करने के बाद काफी अच्छी फैसिलिटीज मिली और काफी अच्छे कोच भी मिले. उम्मीदें तो है लेकिन सबसे ज्यादा उम्मीदें खुद से होती है और हम यहीं पे फोकस कर रहे हैं कि जितना भी ध्यान है अपने प्रैक्टिस पे हो और कैसे मुझे परफॉर्म करना है, इस चीज ज्यादा फोकस कर रहे हैं.
And today in the next segment, that is Know Your Sports, we are talking about what else but athletics. Athletics is the cornerstone for any Olympics event.
We are happy to have with us Mr. Divesh Bhal. He is handling operations and communications of Athletics Federation of India. Divesh ji, welcome to the studios.
Nitesh ji, thank you. Thank you very much for calling me and giving me this opportunity to interact with you and your listeners.
Athletics is mother of all the sports. What is your take on that?
100%. See, anything that has jumping, running, throwing, walking, it is athletics. So you rightly said athletics is the mother of all sports. And before a kid graduates and he picks up a sport, I want to play cricket. You know, before that, he needs to learn how to run, how to throw, how to jump for a catch. This is athletics.
In fact, any player who has taken up sports, we call him an athlete. But athletics as a discipline is different. And what are those various disciplines that come under athletics per se?
So when we talk about athletics as a sporting discipline, see, there are six basic groups you can divide. One is track and field. We all know about track and field, what events take place inside the ground. Then there is road running. What is road running? All your marathons, half marathons, this fall under road running category. Then there is race walking, 20 kilometers, 50 kilometers race walking, which is also done on the road. It can also be done inside the stadium. Fourth category is cross country. Then we have mountain running, trail running. This falls under the category of ultra running. Any distance that is run more than a marathon distance, it falls under the ultra running category. Track and field is the most popular competitive sport when we talk about athletics as a competitive sport. So there are 24 events for men and 23 for women. And then there is nowadays mixed relay also.
24 events you said. And they all are Olympic recognized events.
They are all Olympic recognized events.
So friends, inside the stadium, the multidiscipline stadium, athletics perhaps is the main course of events. And there are 24 events in that athletics. Divesh is going to tell us more about all those 24.
So it's a 24 for men and 23 for women. It makes like 47. Then the World Athletics Body has introduced a new event. It's called mixed relay, where there is a mixed team of two men and two women. So it's close to 40 events. In the sprints category, we have 100 meter, 200 meter and 400 meter. When the same sprint takes place inside an indoor stadium, 100 meters becomes a 60 meter race. In the middle distance, we have 800 and 1500 meters. And 3000 meter steeplechase. In long distance, we have 5000 and 10000 meter races. Then we have hurdles, 110 for men, 100 meter for women. Then 400 meter hurdles, both men and women. Then we have relay races, 4x100 and 4x400 meter relay races. In the jumps, there are four kind of jumps, two horizontal and two vertical. Horizontal jumps are long jump and triple jump. Vertical jumps are high jump and pole vault. Then in the throws category, we again have four throws: shot put, discus throw, hammer throw, javelin throw. Then there is combined events, decathlon and heptathlon. Decathlon is for men, where it's a combination of 10 events, and heptathlon is for women. Then we have race walking, usually done on the roads. So in that, for men, we have two categories, 20 kilometer and 50 kilometer. For women, we have only 20 kilometer race walking. And then there is marathon. Athletics, there are 208 countries, and all 208 countries, they participate in athletics.
Truly, we can call it a global game, actually.
Yes.
What is the status of athletics right now in India? I mean, you coming from Athletics Federation of India, how do you look at our bench strength and the athletes coming from grassroots? How encouraging is the scenario now?
I'll pick one discipline, is javelin throw. The competition at the world level in javelin has gone very high, 96 meters, 97 meters, German athletes are throwing. In India, when Neeraj Chopra again broke his national record, his national record was 88.06 in Asian Games. He improved it by 1 centimeter, 88.07. In that one particular competition, we had three javelin throwers throwing above 80 meters. That has happened first time in Indian history.
One boy has qualified for University Games at China.
Yeah.
Sorry, I'm not able to.
Sahil Silwal. So, Neeraj, Sahil and Shipal. Shipal has already qualified for Olympics. Neeraj has already qualified for Olympics. Then I'll come to race walking. India is one of the very few countries where right now, because last year there was no competition, but in 2021 we started competitions, and in race walking we have 5 athletes who have earned the quota for Olympics, which is a very, very good number. Not many countries have 5 race walkers qualifying, and not just the men, 3 men and 2 women. Then, as we spoke about the relay team, we have a very good strength. We have already qualified for mixed relay in Olympics. 3000 steeplechase men, we have already qualified. So overall, it looks good. Now coming back to your point about grassroots. See, the federation is working very hard, because if you talk about athletics as a sport, that the real talent is somewhere in the deep corners of the country, in the rural area. 17 years ago, our federation started a very unique competition. We wanted to take athletics to the districts of India. So it is called National Inter-District Junior Athletics Meet. In short form, we call it NITJAM. The competition is famous by the name NITJAM. In the last edition in 2019, we had more than 500 districts of India participating in our national inter-district meet.
Mm-hmm.
This is a pure grassroots level competition. Here, you don't...
This is annual event.
This is annual event, non-stop from last 17 years.
Okay.
So athletics has touched lakhs and lakhs of young kids across the districts because of this competition. Every district, they conduct their own competition before sending their team for the final of NIT Jams. So if you calculate, it goes around somewhere more than 1 lakh kids first compete in different districts of India, and then they come for the finals, national finals, which is a 3-day event.
And you rotate it, the venue of the national finals?
The venue we rotate it. We started it from Haridwar, and we had first 8-9 NIT Jam finals in Haridwar, then held in Ranchi, then we took it to Vishakhapatnam. We conducted last 2 editions in Tirupati.
So you said 17 years is long time. Has there any filtration taken place and we have got some talent from these competitions which are showing up at the nationals and international levels?
This is a very, very good question, and I'm glad you asked it. That what we have got out of this competition? Who came out of this competition? Neeraj Chopra, Hima Das, Duti Chand, Manjeet Kaur. These are the athletes who started their career at the district level through this competition.
So having competitions now at district level and national level, of course, how does the Athletics Federation of India supports these young players who are, most of them are coming from very humble background, and every discipline comes for a cost. Disciplines are very costly affair. Any game today is very costly affair. So how do you like support these athletes, young athletes who are perhaps they will shine in one district championship and then maybe lost because of lack of funds?
Thank you for asking me this question, because it is related to something which we have recently launched, a huge project. It is going on, because if you don't have good coaches who knows the basics of the sport, who knows about a little bit about sports science, I'm not saying they should be expert in sports science, and a little bit about nutrition. If we don't have those coaches at the district level, the talent will never come up. This is a very good subject you have touched upon. So Athletics Federation of India, we have realized that it is very important. Talent hunt is one thing, but who will hunt that talent? You have to train the trainers, and at the district level. So AFI has launched a massive coaching program. It is called a pre-level 1 coaches course, where we are asking parents, physical education teachers working in districts of India, anyone who's coaching kids, ex-athletes, present athletes, anyone can join this course, and we are running it online.
Okay, how long is this course? The duration of the course?
It's a 6-day course.
6-day course.
Basically, 3 hours for 6 days, 18 hours course you have to complete online, where our expert coaches directly interact with parents, the participants. Like who are, I know that there are some parents, there are a lot of physical education teachers from various districts, there are ex-athletes, there are some present athletes. So they interact with our experts, and they are being taught about very, very basics of coaching skills, nutrition, how sports science is evolving, how sports science is important. And the one very important thing is, do not overtrain kids.
Okay.
If you overtrain kids at a young age, then his full potential will not be reached when it is required, when he becomes or she becomes a senior athlete.
I think on that note, we have to say goodbye to our listeners, because there's not much time. And I think that there's a need to do a level 2 of athletics. Know your sports, athletics level 2.
Definitely. I'd love to come back again and share more information with you.
Thank you so much, Diveshji. Thank you so
thank
much.
You, Diveshji. Thank you.
Hashtag Cheer for India.
This is Vishwanath Faigaukar. I am PhD research scholar from IIT Bombay. All the best, Team India. Go for it. The medal is ours.
Olympics from past to the present.
You just heard this next episode of a special series, The Saga of Olympics, Past to the Present, by Nitish Arora. We welcome your suggestions and comments regarding our programs on our email ID, englishsw@gmail.com. This broadcast came to you on the 24/7 channel of All India Radio Delhi. Please stand by for the next broadcast.